Good evening to all of you. Our next topic is static data members in C++. This is a very important point from university exam point of view. A data members of a class can be quantified as static. The variables declared inside the class with static keywords are static data members, are also called as static data members. The properties of a static member variable are similar to that of C static variables. A static variable has certain special characteristics. Now, before going to the characteristics, we just recall the concept of static variables in C programming language. We have seen in C programming language, the variables declared with the static keyword are called as static variables, and the static variables are also called as file global variable. These are like public variables in C program, and which always retain the previous call values. And we use such static variables in C programming language for counting the numbers. Take an example of a supermarket where I want to generate a bill, number for the bill. So, I can declare such a field with the static keyword, right? And that variable is called as static variable. Just one thing that you have to remember about static variables in C is that it always retains the previous call values. Its value never gets expired. Now, we will see the characteristics of static data members in C++. There are three important properties that you have to remember about, characteristic that you have to remember. The first characteristic is, it is initialized to 0 automatically when the first object of the class is created. No other initialization is permitted. It means you cannot initialize any other value to the static variable. It gets automatically initialized to 0 when you create the first object of the class. Second important characteristic is, only one copy of that data member is created for the entire class, and it is shared among them, shared by all the objects of the class, no matter how many objects that you create into the program. Third property is, it is visible only within the class, but its life cycle or lifetime is the entire program. It means it is a file global variable, like C programming language. Okay. So, remember these three characteristics about the static data members. Now, we will see a small example on static data member in C++. Consider the class given here, that is Atom. There are two fields that we have declared, data members that we have declared, that is count and number. But count is declared as a static data member. These variables are declared into the private area, data members. Okay. Then in public area, we have only two functions. One is getData, which will going to read data into the number. Once the data into the number of the object is read, immediately we are going to increment the count value, that is count plus plus. Then we have another function, that is getCount, which is just responsible for displaying the value of the count. And here we close the class Atom with the help of semicolon. Remember one thing, in this static data member program, we have to declare or define, we have to define the static variables outside the class the way we define member function defined outside the class. So, this static count variable is defined here in this line outside the class. The same format we have used, the return type of the function, here we have the declaration of the function, data type of the variable, then the class name, then scope register operator and count variable. This tells the compiler that count is a variable of type static which belongs to the class Item. This line is very, very important in this program. Now, when you go to the main program, we declare the objects of the class. We have created objects A, B and C here. Now, if you remember the properties of the static variable, or static data member, whenever you create the first object of the class, immediately the value of the static variable count becomes 0. Okay. So, as soon as you declare that object A, value of count variable becomes 0. Then, if you see these three lines where we call getCount function, A.getCount, B.getCount and C.getCount. These three objects are calling getCount function. So, what would be the value inside the count variable? Right now, the value is 0 only because we have not called get data function, because we incremented count value inside get data function. So, output of these three lines is count equal to 0, count equal to 0 and count equal to 0. Later on, we call another function, that is get data from the same class. Here we are reading the data inside the object A through get data function, A dot get data 100 semicolon. It means that the value 100 goes to object A. After assigning value 100 to object A, the next line will going to increment the count value by 1. So at the end of this line, count becomes 1. When you read the data into the second object, count becomes 2. When you read the data into the third object, count becomes 3. At the end of the last line, what was there in the count variable? The value 3. So after reading the data in all the objects, if I again call the same function getCount by different objects, A.getCount, B.getCount and C.getCount, I will get the output as 3, count equal to 3, count equal to 3 and count equal to 3. So this is a small program where it illustrated you how to declare static variable, how to define the static variable outside the class and how to call it into the main program. You notice into this program that the count variable is just responsible for incrementing the values of the variable count, okay, and it returns the previous call value. When we read the data into A object, the count was 1, but when you read the data into second object, the count becomes 2. It doesn't mean that it expires the previous call value. It always retained, static variable always retains the previous call values. So we can use this same static data member which was available in C programming as well as in C++ for generating the build numbers, where you need always the new numbers on the build, correct? In that case, you have to retain the previous call value. So this is the best example for understanding static data member. So now, if you have any doubt, you can ask me inside the chat room and try this program at your home. If there are no doubts, we can move to the next lecture also, next topic. Thank you.